This recording shows how to install Talon voice control software on a Windows 10 operating system. The point of this is to be able to control my computer with my voice, and installing the software that allows that is quite obviously the first step. So the instructions are right here in the getting started. Let's see how far we can get. Step one, download and install Talon for your operating system. Let's see where that takes us. It takes us to the main page where we are going to download Talon for Windows. Now, I could pretend that I was going to sit here for 2 minutes and wait for it to download. Or I could go to the download that I already downloaded and open it up. Do I want to allow this app to make changes to my device? Yes. So we are going to go through the setup, accept the licensing agreement without reading it as usual. And Talon is going to be installed in C program files Talon. We will also add a start menu folder. And here we go. Looks like it's going pretty fast, which is a good thing. While that's installing, let's take a look at step two. Run the Talon app. If we Alt-Tab. All right, Talon has been installed on your computer. Click Finish. We will click Finish. And here's this new pair of shortcuts on my desktop. I want to open Talon. All right, this is where things get a little bit odd because we are nowhere near done with the setup yet. So, down here in my system tray is Talon. But in order to have Talon, we have to have a set of magic words that we can tell Talon we need voice commands. Talon doesn't come pre-installed with voice commands. We need to add them. Also, we need to add an engine, which will be step four. But we'll follow these instructions here, do it step by step. Add some scripts. So first we need to open the Talon home directory. This is %appdata/Talon on Windows. Talon has a menu in the system tray near the clock, so I could open this appdata/Talon using the system tray. So let's go down to this icon and go to scripting, like the instructions say, and open /Talon, or more accurately on Windows, appdata/Talon. All right, so we found this folder. What are we supposed to do next? We are supposed to add some scripts to the .talon/user folder. So this is Talon, and then this is the user folder. And there's nothing in here. The most common script, the best way to get started right now is to clone knausj_talon into your repo. So let's go to knausj. That takes us to GitHub. And we want to download the Windows version of knausj backslash talon by cloning it into the repository. So where do I find the code? If I do code, so I click on this code button and I want to download the zip file of it because I don't know how to use a command line on Windows. So the zip file contains everything that I would want. And now let's open it. And go one further down. Well, we want to go back to following the instructions. So the instructions say getting scripts, download, copy knausj underscore talon into the tilde slash dot talon slash user, or on Windows app data slash talon slash user. So we want to copy that, and it's actually knausj talon dot master, not knausj talon. And we're going to copy it into user. Paste. And there we go. So we're still not done, because Talon also needs a voice engine. I'm not using the proper terminology there, but let's go back to the instructions and see what they call it. Instructions. Okay, so step four. If you don't have if you have Dragon started up at the same time as Talon, this is not a Dragon tutorial, we're not going to do that. If you don't have Dragon, you will need to set up wav2Letter. See wav2Letter setup. So, wav2Letter, we're going to go and download it. Now, as you can see, I don't really want to sit here for 27 minutes waiting for my voice engine to download. And what wav2Letter is, I think, is the thing that takes the audio files and processes them and turns them into words. So going back to the instructions, wav2Letter setup. We want to copy the Talon contents of talon-w2l into Talon home. So it says be careful not to completely overwrite w2l or a slash user if you've already put other files you care about in there. We haven't. This is a fresh installation of Talon, so no need to worry about that. So we're going to go back to our home, which is, this is Talon, this is the home directory. And now I'm going to already take my pre-downloaded version of WTL, extract it. And let's check out what's in the user. Engines.py is in the user. W2L is in the user. There's a new folder. We're going to take all of this and copy it into the home folder. Okay. At this point, I'm pretty sure we should have a working Talon installation. So let's test that. Command history. Well, let's restart it. Quit Talon. Now, this menu is Talon booting up as Talon gets closer. Yeah, now it should be on. Command history. Talon responded by showing me the command history. Help alphabet. Alphabet close. Help close. Talon sleep. And as you can see, I computer is now responding to voice commands, which means that I have successfully installed Talon anew on my Windows 10 computer.